Good afternoon. Thank you so much for tuning in. I wanted to come to you guys on a weekly basis to share some tips about how to protect your intellectual property. If this is your first time watching a video from me, I am Takora Davis and I'm the Creator's Lawyer. I own the Creator's Law Firm, and what I do is I'm an intellectual property and business attorney. As an IP and business attorney, I help my clients build, grow, and protect their businesses by providing them with luxury legal service. Some of the things that I do is help them protect their trademarks, copyrights, put essential contracts in place to protect their business, and I work a lot with creative entrepreneurs and small business owners. One of the questions that I often get asked is, how can you obtain a trademark and a copyright, but they call it a poor man's trademark and a poor man's copyright? And I'm going to tell you guys about this today. So what is a poor man's trademark, poor man's patent, poor man's copyright? What that is pretty much a way to document that you were the first owner or the originator or author of a creative work. And so what people have done is they created a system, whether it be in a letter, picture, some sort of documentation, maybe even an email, where they email that to themselves or they mail it to themselves or they get it notarized to show that they have created this work on a specific date. And a lot of times people will mail it to themselves to make sure that it's protected. So pretty much the rationale behind something like this is that if they are not able to pay the fees to actually register their trademark, patent, or copyright through the U.S. Postal Service, through a notary, or through mailing it to themselves, they can pretty much maintain ownership over their creative work. And if somebody beats them to the punch that actually has more money to register a copyright or a patent or a trademark, that they can show that, hey, I have evidence or proof that helped me pretty much establish that I'm the rightful owner over this intellectual property. So I'm not exactly sure where the concept or the notion came from, but how you can obtain one of these is you cannot. It is actually a myth that a poor man's patent or poor man's copyright or a poor man's trademark is going to really be something that you can use in the court of law to show that you are actually someone who can, you know, assert their ownership rights over intellectual property. Especially in systems such as ours, where in our government we have an intellectual property system where we go to the United States Patent and Trademark Office on the federal level to register our intellectual property, such as a trademark or a patent or a copyright. Or there are state laws and state statutes that you can pretty much comply with that give you common law rights. So this is actually a myth. There's no way for you to obtain a poor man's patent, a poor man's trademark, or a poor man's copyright. The best way to protect your intellectual property is to register it federally. So let's break it down. There are five big categories of intellectual property. The first is patents. Patents protect inventions, so things that function and work. A trademark protects brand identifiers, such as your business name, logo, tagline. A copyright protects literary or artistic work, so books, music, poetry, sculptures. Trade secrets are like, you know, the Coca-Cola formula that's hidden away in a vault. So these are secrets or proprietary formulas that are so integral to the way that you do business that you must protect them. And then finally, we have right of publicity law, which pretty much is your face used for a commercial image or purpose. So as I stated, these things are actually a myth. There's no way that you can obtain a poor man's patent, trademark, or copyright. In order to get the full scope of protection for your intellectual property, you must register it federally. Why is that important? Registering a copyright with a copyright office gives you access to federal courts in the event somebody takes your idea and runs with it. It also pretty much gives you not only access to federal courts, but a statutory bar of recovery of $150,000. And finally, it maintains an evidence trail. So it shows that you're the rightful owner of the intellectual property. So if you register your work with the Copyright Office, it creates this line or this assumption in the law that you're the rightful owner. You simply writing out your copyright or writing out your literary artistic work and documenting it and emailing it to yourself or getting it notarized is not sufficient to protect your rights. So I know that this is a myth that's going around of a poor man's copyright, but that's really not going to do you justice in the event that somebody takes your intellectual property. You want to make sure that you assert your rights appropriately. Okay, next. Same thing with a poor man's trademark. That could be you have a great business idea, you want to open up a business 6 months from now or a year from now, and you have an amazing name, but you don't want anyone to take your name. So what do? You say, okay, here's my business idea, you write it out, you put the name of the business on a piece of paper, you put it in the mail and you mail it to yourself, or you email it to yourself, or you take it to a notary public and then ask them to notarize it, stating that yes, the information on this paper or page is what I put out there, and that it's true. And so you think that potentially that you doing that is enough to assert your rights over the trademark. Trademark rights arise through use, which means that you must use that name for your business with, you know, when you're selling goods and services. Simply emailing it or mailing it to yourself or getting it notarized is not sufficient to protect your trademark rights. You can either do one of two things to protect your trademark rights. Begin to use the trademark in your business and then file a federal registration, a federal application for your trademark. Or if you know that you have a great business idea but you're not quite at the point where you're ready to open and begin selling, you can still file a separate type of trademark application where you, in a sense, reserve the business name. I can help with either of those things, and it's really important because a lot of people sometimes have the same idea. So it's best for us to protect our unique ideas, but there are methods and systems that we already have in place in this particular country that we can do that. And the same thing with patents. It's best to consult with a patent attorney, which I am not, but I can certainly refer you out to several of my colleagues who are patent attorneys if you have a unique invention idea. So just know that if you want to trademark your business name, that's what trademarks are for. They are for marks that are used, thank you LaToya, marks that are used in your business. You cannot patent a business name, you cannot copyright a business name. And even if you did copyright a logo, that's not going to stop somebody from taking the business name in the logo and opening up a business, because that's not what copyright is for. Copyright will protect just the design of your logo. It won't stop somebody from taking the name that might be in your logo and then using it for a business. So just share this with your family and friends. Let them know that this really does not exist. You cannot get a poor man's patent, poor man's trademark, or poor man's copyright. Those things just are not eligible. It just does not exist. And I know that probably maybe at one point in time in this country or other countries it did exist, but we have a method and system of laws that are put in place that we need to take advantage of and use to our good and to our benefit. A poor man's copyright or a poor man's trademark or patent is not a substitute for registration federally. And there's actually nothing in the law, there's nothing in the copyright law, which is U.S. Copyright Act of 1976, or the Lanham Act, which pretty much pertains to trademarks, that would give you even an exception to the rule to show that you are actually the rightful owner. The best thing to do is to register your trademarks and your copyrights and even your patents federally. If you guys have any further questions about this, please just leave it in the comments. If you know that a friend of yours is an entrepreneur and they were thinking that this is possibly a way that they could do to protect their business, tag them in the video. Let them know if you think that this information would be helpful to them and tag them. Share it on your timeline so that we can begin to educate our community about intellectual property, because it's really important for us to share the knowledge, especially in terms of people pursuing entrepreneurship more and more. We have to empower them with the right legal knowledge that they need so that they can use the tools to their advantage. I don't want anyone to open themselves up to risk because they just were simply not aware. So thank you so much for tuning in. I hope that this was extremely helpful and it debunks some myths for you. But like I said, there's no way to get a poor man's patent or a poor man's copyright or a poor man's trademark, because it simply just does not exist. If you're just joining us, welcome, but watch the video back from the beginning. And thank you so much for tuning in. Have a great Thursday.